never give your attention towards beauty, because beauty is not your duty, but beauty and duty will make you bright. With this thought, children, let us begin the today's session. In this session, we will learn about factorization and prime factorization of a number. Okay? Which is very important to learn the further concepts of mathematics, especially to know the nature and properties of numbers. Okay, children, let us start the today's session in which we are going to learn about the factorization and the prime factorization. Okay? Before we go to learn about factorization and prime factorization, let us just recapitulate what is meant by a factor and then proceed. Okay? In our previous classes, we have learned about factor of a number. Okay? See here, children, factor means it is a number which divides another number exactly and leaves the remainder zero. Okay? But today we can learn one more definition for factor or factors of a number. See here, factors can also be defined like this. Okay? Factors are the numbers which give product when they are multiplied. Okay? What is one more definition for factors? Factors are the numbers which give product when they are multiplied. Let us justify the statement. Here, 1 and 20 are the factors of 20 because they give the product 20 when they are multiplied. Okay? Here, 2 and 10 are the numbers which are multiplied to get the product 20. That is why 2 and 10 must be the factors of 20. Okay? Here, 2 and 10 are the factors of 20 because they give the product 20 when they are multiplied. Here, 2 and 12 are the factors of 24 because they give the product 24 when they are multiplied. So, children, in this example, 5 and 25 are called the factors of 125 because they give the product 125 when they are multiplied. Okay? See here, children, 2, 2, 6 are multiplied to get the product 24. That is why 2, 2, 6 must be factors of 24. Yes or no, you can check. Okay? Similarly, the number 24 can be the product of 2, 2, 2, 3. Okay? If I multiply all these 4 numbers, will I get 24 or not? Yes, I am getting definitely 24. That is why this 2, 2, 2, 3 must be the factors of 24. Therefore, children, here the numbers are multiplied to get the product. Okay? Therefore, the numbers which are multiplied to get the product are called factors of that product. Okay? So, children, after the multiplication of these two numbers, you will get this 12 as a product, no? Then this 3 and 4 must be factors of 12. Okay? After the multiplication of this 6 and 2, if you get this 12 as a product, then these two numbers must be the factors of 12. Okay? In case, after the multiplication of these two numbers, if you do not get the number 12 as the product, then this 6 and 2 are not the factors of 12. So, children, after the multiplication of these two numbers, will you get the product 20? Yes. Then this 2 and 10 must be the factors of 20. Okay? Similarly, after the multiplication of these three numbers, will you get 20 as the product? Yes. Then this 2, 2, 5 must be the factors of 20. Similarly, after the multiplication of these three numbers, will you get the number 12 as the product? Yes. then this 2, 2, 3 must be the factors of 12. If these numbers are not the factors of 12, then after the multiplication of these three numbers, you will not get the 12 as product. Okay? If you say that 12 is the product of these three numbers, then these three numbers must be the factors of 12. Okay? Similarly, if you say that 50 is the product of these three numbers, then these three numbers must be the factors of 50. Okay? That is why we can say factors are also the numbers which give product when they are multiplied. Okay? This helps us to study about the factorization and prime factorization. Okay, children? After having recapitulated about the factor or factors of a number, now let us start what do we mean by factorization of a number and then prime factorization of a number. Okay, let us proceed. Now students, let us understand the meaning of factorization of a number and then we will go to study about the prime factorization of a number. Okay, see here, let us understand what do we mean by factorization. Okay, it is a process or a way of writing a number as the product of its factors. Okay, what is factorization? It is a process or it is a way of writing or representing or expressing a number as the product of its factors. Okay? So children, according to the definition, let us take some examples and justify our answer. Here 12 is equal to 1 into 12 or 12 is equal to 12 into 1. Both are same. Because here 12 is the product of 1 and 12 or 12 is the product of 12 and 1. But after the multiplication of these two, I get this 12, no? Then this 1 into 12 is called the factorization of 12. Okay? Similarly, after the multiplication of 12 and 1, I get 12 as a product, no? This is called the factorization of 12. Okay? The same 12 is equal to the product of 2 into 6 or 12 is equal to 6 into 2. But after multiplication of 6 and 2, will you get 12? Then this 2 into 6 is called factorization of 12. And 2 and 6 are called the factors involved in the factorization. After the multiplication of 6 and 2, will you get 12 as the product? Therefore, this 6 into 2 is called the factorization of 12 and 6 and 2 are called the factors involved in the factorization. The same 12 is equal to 3 into 4 or the number 12 is also equal to the product of 4 into 3. Here 3 into 4 and 4 into 3 both are same. But after the multiplication of 4 into 3, do I get 12? Yes, 4 threes are 12. That is why this 3 into 4 is called factorization of 12. Okay? And similarly, after the multiplication of 3 and 4, will I get 12 as the product? Then this 4 into 3 is called factorization of 12. Okay? Here, you have written 12 as the product of 1 into 12. You have written 12 as the product of 2 into 6. You have written 12 as the product of 3 into 4. Therefore, writing a number as the product of its factors is called factorization. Okay? Therefore, children, factorization of a number means it is a process or a method or a way of writing a number as the product of its factors. Okay? Let us take one more example here. 54. 54 is equal to 1 into 54 also or 54 is equal to 54 into 1 also. But after multiplying these two numbers, I get 54 as the product. That is why this 54 into 1 is called the factorization of 54. And similarly, after multiplying this 1 into 54, I get the product 54. Therefore, this 1 into 54 is the factorization of 54. The 54 can also be factorized in one more way. How? 2 into 27 or 54 is equal to 27 into 2. But after multiplication of these two, will I get the product 54? Yes, that is why 27 into 2 is called the factorization of 54. Or after multiplying 27 into 2 or 2 into 27, will I get the product as 54? Yes. Therefore, this 2 into 27 is also called the factorization of 54, and 27 into 2 is also called factorization of 54. The same 54 can also be expressed as the product of some other numbers, which are those 3 into 18 or 18 into 3. After the multiplication of 18 into 3, will I get the product 54? Yes. Then this 18 into 3 is called the factorization of 54. And after the multiplication of 3 into 18, will I get the product 54? Yes. Then 3 into 18 is called the factorization of 54. Here similarly, children, 6 into 9 is also 54 and 9 into 6 is also 54. Therefore, 6 into 9 is also factorization of 54 and 9 into 6 is also factorization of 54. Okay. Here, the factorization need not necessarily be the product of two factors. You can write or express a number as the product of 3 factors, 4 factors, 5 factors, etc. Okay. See your children, 54 is the product of 2, 3, 9. Okay. After the multiplication of these 3 numbers, will you get 54 as the product? Yes. How? 9 3s are 27, 27 2s are 54. Thus, after the multiplication of these 3 numbers, you are getting 54. Then, this 2, 3, 9 must be factors of 54, and this 2 into 3 into 9 is called the factorization of 54. Okay. Similarly, children, 54 is the product of 9 into 2 into 3. After the multiplication of these 3 numbers, will you get the number 54 as product? Yes. Therefore, this is the factorization of 54. And here, the 9 into 2 into 3 is called the factorization of 54, and 3, 2, 9 are called the factors of 54, and the numbers 9, 2, 3 are the factors involved in the factorization of 54. Okay. Similarly, after the multiplication of 3 into 3 into 6, will you get 54? Yes. How? 6 3s are 18, 18 3s are 54. Therefore, after the multiplication of these 3 numbers, you are getting 54 as product. Therefore, these 3 numbers must be factors of 54. Okay. These 3 numbers are the factors of 54, and this is called the factorization of 54. Okay. See your children, in one factorization, sometimes the same numbers may repeat. No problem. Okay. Similarly, 54 is also the product of 6 into 3 into 3. Yes. 3 3s are 9. 9 6 are 54. Therefore, 54 is equal to product of these 3 numbers. Then these 3 numbers must be factors of 54 according to the definition of factors. Okay. Then children, after the multiplication of these 3 numbers, you get this 54 as product. That is why this is the factorization of 54, and these are the factors involved in the factorization of 54. Okay. Similarly, 10 is product of 1 into 10. Therefore, this 1 into 10 is the factorization of 10. The same 10 can also be the product of 10 into 1. Therefore, 10 into 1 is also the factorization of 10. Or 10 is also equal to 2 into 5. Therefore, 2 into 5 is the factorization of 10. Okay. 5 into 2 will give us the product 10. That's why writing 10 as a product of its factors is called the factorization of 10. And here 5 into 2 is also the factorization of 10. And 5 and 2 are the factors involved in the factorization. Okay. Therefore, children, I hope you learned what do you mean by factorization of a number. Okay. But now let us go to the important concept, prime factorization of a number. Okay. After having learnt about the factorization of a number, now let us learn about prime factorization of a number. Okay. Let us understand what is prime factorization. See here, children, it is a process or a way of writing or expressing a number as the product of its prime factors. Okay? See here, factorization means it is a process or a way of writing a number as the product of its factors. Okay? But prime factorization of a number means it is a process or a way of writing or expressing a number as the product of its prime factors. Okay? Here, the factors involved in the factorization may be prime or may not be prime. Okay? But here, the factors involved in the factorization must be prime numbers. That is why, children, it is called prime factorization. Okay? For justification, let us take an example. 12 is the product of 2 into 6. Therefore, here 2 into 6 gives us the product 12. Therefore, 2 and 6 must be factors of 12. And writing this 12 as the product of the factors of 12 is called factorization of 12. Okay? Here, 12 can also be written as 2 into 2 into 3. Yes or no? Yes. Why? 3 2s are 6. 6 2s are 12. Therefore, children, 12 is the product of these three numbers. And then these three numbers must be the factors of 12. Okay? Then, this 2 into 2 into 3 is called the factorization of 12. Okay? Here, I have expressed 12 as the product of its factors. Okay? And here the factors involved are all prime numbers. Here 2 is factor of 12 also, prime number also. 2 is factor of 12 also and prime number also. 3 is factor of 12 also and prime number also. That is why here 12 has been expressed as the product of prime factors. Okay? That is why this is called the prime factorization of 12. Okay? In the prime factorization, here the number 2 has repeated 2 times. Okay? Let us take one more example, 54. Here 54 is the product of 2 into 27. Then 2 and 27 must be the factors of 54. Therefore, here 2 and 27 are factors of 54 also. And the product of these two numbers gives 54 also. That is why this is called factorization of 54. Okay? Why is it not called prime factorization? Because the factors involved are the factors of 54. But both the factors are not prime factors. That is why this is simply factorization but not prime factorization. Because 2 is a prime number and 27 is a composite number in the factorization. Okay? The 54 can also be written as 2 into 3 into 9. Okay? Is the product of 2 into 3 into 9 54? Yes. How? 9 3s are 27, 27 2s are 54. Therefore, the product of these three numbers gives 54. Then these three numbers must be the factors of 54. And this 2 into 3 into 9 is called factorization of 54. But this is simply factorization of 54, but not the prime factorization of 54. Do you know why? Here the factors involved are all not the prime numbers. Here 2 is factor of 54 also, prime number also. That's why 2 is prime factor of 54. 3 is factor of 54 also and prime number also. That is why 3 is prime factor of 54. But whereas the number 9 involved in the factorization is factor of 54, but 9 is not the prime factor of 54. That is why 2 into 3 into 9 is simply factorization but not the prime factorization of 54. Okay? Look at the next step here. The 54 can be the product of 2, 3, 3, 3 also. How? Here 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 will give 54. Yes or no? Yes. Come on, check it. 3 3s are 9, 9 3s are 27, 27 2s are 54. Therefore, children, 54 is the product of these numbers. That is why these numbers must be the factors of 54. Okay? And this 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 is called the factorization of 54. What type of factorization it is? It is the prime factorization of 54. Do you know why? Here, the 54 is product of these numbers. Okay, the 54 has been written or has been expressed or has been represented as the product of 2 into 3 into 3 into 3. Okay, that is why this is the factorization of 54. But in the factorization of 54, the factors involved are all prime numbers. See here, 2 is factor of 54 and prime number also. That's why it is prime factor of 54. Here, these all 3s are prime numbers also and factors of 54 also. Therefore, here children, you have written the 54 as the product of prime factors of 54. That is why this is called the prime factorization of 54. Okay? Sometimes we stop here only for the factorization or prime factorization. If the same numbers have repeated, we will write those repeated number in the exponential form. Okay? See here, there is only 1, 2, we write 2. And here, 3 is multiplied 3 times. That is why I write it as 3 cube or 3 raised to the power of 3. Okay? If the same number is multiplied 3 times, we will write it the power raised to 3. If the same number is multiplied 4 times, we write the power raised to 4. Okay? So children, here the prime factorization of 54 is equal to 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 also, or the prime factorization of 54 is 2 into 3 raised to the power of 3 also. Okay, here 54 is also equal to 2 raised to 1, because if there is nothing in the power's place, we can write 1. Therefore 2 can be written as 2 raised to 1 into, and 3 raised to 3 is 3 raised to 3. Therefore, 54 is equal to 2 raised to 1 into 3 raised to 3 is also called the prime factorization of 54, or 54 is equal to 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 is also called the prime factorization of 54. Therefore, children, the prime factorization of 54 can be 2 into 3 into 3 into 3 also, or the prime factorization of 54 can be equal to 2 raised to 1 into 3 raised to 3 also. Both are same. The factor 3 has been repeated 3 times. Therefore, I have written this product of 3 into 3 into 3 as 3 raised to 3. Here it is in expansion form and here it is in exponential form. Okay? Where 3 is base and this 3 is power. Let us take one more example here, children. 63 is the product of 3 into 21. That is why the product of 3 and 21 will give us 63. Okay. Then 3 and 21 are the factors of 63. Okay. And this 3 into 21 is called the factorization of 63. But here 3 is prime factor of 63. But 21 is not the prime factor of 63. That is why 3 into 21 is called the factorization of 63, but not the prime factorization of 63. But the same 63 can also be written as the product of 3 into 3 into 7. Okay? Here, 7 threes are 21, 21 threes are 63. Therefore, children, 63 is the product of 3 into 3 into 7, and that is why 3, 3, 7 must be the factors of 63. And since 63 is expressed as the product of these factors, it is called factorization of 63. See here, 3 into 3 into 7 is called the factorization of 63. And here, the numbers involved in the factorization are prime numbers. See here, this 3 and 3 are prime numbers also and factors of 63 also. This 7 is prime number also and factor of 63 also. Here, 63 is the product of its prime factors. Therefore, expressing a number as the product of its prime factors is called prime factorization of 63. Therefore, children, the prime factorization of 63 is equal to 3 into 3 into 7. Okay? But here, 3 into 3 can also be written as 3 square or 3 raised to the power of 2. Okay? Into 7, 7. Therefore, 63 is the product of 3 square into 7 also. Then this 3 square into 7 is also called factorization of 63. But in the factorization, which are the factors involved? 3 and 7. What type of factors are these? 3 and 7 are the prime factors. That is why 3 square into 7 is called the prime factorization of 63. Okay, here the 7 raised to the power of nothing is there. If any base has no power, we can write as 1. Okay, therefore here children, 3 is base and 2 is power. Here 7 is base. If any base doesn't have any number, we can write 1 there. Okay, therefore 63 is equal to 3 square into 7 raised to 1. Okay, this is also the prime factorization of 63. Okay. Ultimately children, if we compare the factorization of a number and prime factorization of a number, both are same except in one way. That is, in factorization, the factors involved may be prime or may not be prime. But in the prime factorization, the factors involved in the factorization must be prime. Hope you have learnt about the factors, factorization and prime factorization of a number. Okay? So ultimately we can conclude that factorization is a process or a way of writing a number as the product of 2 factors, 3 factors, 4 factors, etc. And here the factors may or may not be prime numbers, right? But the prime factorization of a number means it is a process or a way of writing or expressing a number as the product of its prime factors. Okay, the factors involved in the factorization must be prime numbers, and the number may be the product of 2 prime factors or product of 3 prime factors, 4 prime factors, 5 prime factors, etc. Okay, but children, if the same factor is repeated in the factorization, that is written in the exponential form or index form, means with base and power. Okay, I hope you have understood about the factorization of a number and the prime factorization of a number. Okay, see you. Thank you. Hi children, today I think you have enjoyed this session and learnt about the factorization and prime factorization of a number. Okay, see you tomorrow. Goodbye.